Soundarya Lahari, composed in the 8th century AD.
The hymn consists of a total of 100 verses.
The legend of Soundarya Lahari is often substantiated by the distinct difference that is present in the two sets of verses. Ananda Lahari, verse 1 to 41, and Soundarya Lahari, verse 42 to 100. A total of 100 verses. This has massive acceptance among the Sanskrit scholars, students, and enthusiasts. The first 41 verses deal with the mantra, yantra, and tantra practices of Shakta cult. The principle of Kundalini yoga are also elaborately dealt with. The verses are on a metaphysical plane, describing the philosophical and spiritual aspects of Shakti worship. A notable feature of this set of verses is that the verses are not interlinked in any way. They stand apart. The language is also slightly transcendental in nature. This part is also called Ananda Lahari, Waves of Bliss. The second part is a description of Devi from crown to feet. These verses are said to be written by Shankaracharya himself as a description of the vision of Devi he experienced. This set of verses makes generous use of alankara, figures of speech of Sanskrit poetics. This part is also known as Soundarya Lahari, an adulation of beauty, though the term is now commonly applied to the entire 100 verses. There also exist 3 additional verses whose authorship and relation with the main body of 100 verses are debated. However, these 3 verses do not typically form part of Soundarya Lahari, as there is some controversy about their origin.